Woohoo! This is part two of digitizing this cute little doggy guy. And in this video, we're going to come up with more ways to digitize him so he looks good. But first, my intro. Now, we are going to work with this, and it's similar to the auto digitizing, but not quite the same. So this is way number three. So let me go back to, let's do digitize closed shape, fill, and tatami. And what we're going to do, if this is big enough, now you can't really do this if it's small, is that we are just going to basically outline the shapes. And I'm just right clicking and left clicking, and I made a mistake there. So let's backspace back, because this one needs to be a left click. And we're going to fill in, it's hard to do with it close up, but we're going to fill in these darker areas that require, I think, filling. And it just depends on how you look at it, but this would not look good really small, I don't think. So we're going to go up here. Let's take it in pieces. Let's go up here and do this part. So this can take a few minutes to do, but it has a pretty nice effect when you're done. I don't mind. And you don't have to be precise. That's the other fun part about it. And let's see, this will be part one. See how it looks? Now, again, I'm going to want to take off the underlay. Let's put like this kind of a color on it. That's how it kind of looks, and it's all in one. Take the pull comp off, and you know, you can get creative. So you could put satin stitches in this part, and you can do, let's do another part just so you get the idea. Now, nobody said anything was quick in embroidery, right? It's going to take a few minutes to do. But you can make it how you want, how you like it. And I think it'll be really cool. So I'm just going to go here and down. And I'm left clicking and right clicking. He's so cute. But this is how you work with, you know, crappy pictures like this. You can, there's a lot of ways around it, and you can literally make art out of not a whole lot. Now, depending on the size, you can put, you know, a lot of detail in it or not. It's going to show up if it's larger, so you might want to be more precise. But if it's small, then you won't want to. But see how that looks? That's not going to be bad at all. Let's change the color. I forgot to do that. So that's how you would do that one. Now let's do one of the paws. There's more than one way to do these paws, and I'm gonna, you know, put a little artistic licensing in there. So tatami, that's fine. So we are going to left click and right click on the outside of the shape and try, you know, to make it, see how that curve went up there? That's fine because it's going to make it even smoother looking. Left click at the bottom, and then we're going to cut out this part just like this. Perfect. And go enter. I mean, that doesn't look great, right? Let's go to stitching, and I always want to make sure I take that off. Oh, I cranked something up. So Control Z, Control Z. Yeah, thank you. Sorry about that. So that's one. And then we want to digitize holes. And we can't see them. So let's take our true view off. And now we can see them. And let's just left click and right click. Left at the bottom. Right click here. And press enter. And enter again, and we've got it. So we want to digitize another hole. And there we go. Kind of follow along, but make it a little bit nicer as we go along. There we go. Two enters, and then, oops, no, wrong one. Whoops, digitize holes. Thank you. And this one is a little bit bigger. I kind of like how it looks so far. But remember, if you can't see underneath it, then you need to take off the true view. I leave the true view on a lot of times, or most of the time when we're doing videos, because it's hard to see otherwise. It's hard for you guys to see. So let's put it back on and then you can see. Let's change the color. Ooh, see, it didn't make it big enough. So that's a bit of a problem. So what we have to do is go into reshape here, and we need to make them a little bit bigger so the cuts show up. We want them a little bit wider here. We must have pull comp on. But always check, because, you know, it doesn't look like a paw if we don't have these cutouts. Now, you could fill them with a different color, but I'm going to try to keep this one black and white. But you see how easy it is to do? And we just kind of make it. And then if you're looking at it like this, you can reshape it how you want as well. I would also change the angle of it. That makes it look flat, but you see how it changes the shape? Let's try that way. I kind of like it better like that, and there's nothing wrong with having it different than the foot, the rest of the dog. But isn't that cute? I think that's really cute. Now, you want to play around with it. Obviously, we have to do just a little bit more on this to make it how I like it, but you can play around with it. That's one of the advantages of True View. So play around with it, get it how you like. And I'm liking that. I think that's absolutely perfect. So that's way number three for the dog. It's going to take a little while to finish it, but that's okay. Look how cute it is when you remove the picture. You can clearly see that it's a dog and it's nice. And I actually really like the paw that I just did. So what's our last way of doing it? Let's do something completely different. And again, this one has to be on a larger scale. And what we're going to do is digitize blocks, because these are beautiful column stitches that we can do, and they're like different widths. So you can't just do, you know, digitize open shape and change it to satin. I'll show you the difference. Let's start. Let's do one. So digitize open shape. Let's do this. And I'm left clicking and right clicking. And there, except for I didn't change it to satin. So let's do that now. Where is it? There it is. Satin. Let's change the color to something really bright. So that doesn't look as good as it could to me. So let's try it with the blocks. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you guys can see it. So digitize blocks. And if you remember, with digitize blocks, it's an up and down motion. Now I'll zoom right in so you can see, but you see it's elastic there. And you can right click, and this one's attached. So you know which one is the top and which one is the bottom, is what I'm getting at. So right click, left click, up, down, and keep going. Now the lines that I'm putting in are angle lines. So you always want to be aware of that. You could move them around, you know, when you're done, if you kind of made a mistake on one and didn't quite get it right. But keep it in mind. Now, this one is big and it's going to have a split satin on it. So what can we do about that to fix it? Well, I made my angles a bit too long. We need to take off our true view so we can see. See what I did there? It's not quite right. So we can move things around so our angle lines are a little bit better and they're not going across like this. That was my mistake. And now we have it fixed. So you have to keep track of it. Let's practice one more time and make sure we get this right for the digitized blocks. But doesn't this look much better than that? You can taper the edges like I did. Let's do a small one and we'll talk about the edges as well. So I'm going to start here. One, and then this one, and this one, and I'm left clicking and right clicking, and you don't have to do them too close. You don't have to spend all day left clicking and right clicking. Spread it out a little bit more. It also helps you to get nice curves when you do that. Now again, this is going to take you guys a little while to do, but it's fine. It'll look fantastic. So enter and change it to satin. Isn't that pretty? Doesn't that look good? Let's move this guy red. I would tweak it a little bit there. My shaping is a little bit off. It's hard to see. But doesn't that look cute with the edge? Now, you could cheat a little bit on this one. And let's move out and you can see. I would smooth these out a little bit. But if you click on calligraphy, it's going to change it. And you know, it's kind of odd looking, but let's put it on here and we're gonna have a whole bunch of more. You could get away with that. I think that looks really good. It would be cool, make sure it stitches out properly. I do like this one a little bit better, even though I didn't quite do it properly. We could delete that one and forget that it ever happened and try it again. I'm not sure what I did, but it happens. So fill and satin. So let's do it again. I think I got wrong on my angles a little bit. Trying too hard maybe. So again, you don't have to be perfectly precise. This guy is going to have a little bit of artistic, you know, ability in him. No matter what you do, we're going to digitize it and everyone's will be different. And that's why I'm giving you guys a little bit of options for it. One more and see how I do the bottom to make it tapered. I did the last one out here and then this one, click and enter, and it becomes tapered. So, okay, yeah, that's much better. I don't know what I did the first time. I'm sure I'll see it in editing and go, no, it's terrible. So make sure your picture is the right size for this, but doesn't this look cute? Now, I wouldn't do the paws in satin stitch. I think they'll be too big, but you can play around with this. This is actually a little bit thick for my liking. So take the pull comp off is one of the first things I do. We could add effects to it. Now there's nothing wrong with putting a feathered edge. And you can layer the feathered edge. It gives it, you know, it looks kind of weird when you're up close. But if you move back, I mean, that's a whole new effect either. Don't be afraid to work with effects and different things. I like it on one side. But you can play around with it and make it more or less ragged. There is radial fill. No, that's not going to work. You could do an embossed fill, but you have to make sure that the size is right. I think either just plain satin stitches or, you know, the feathered edge would work just fine. So far, that's a few ways. You can let me know in the comments which way you like best. I think for me, Don would like this one. This is his style. And I'm going to try to get him to do one and so we can see it. I kind of like this one. And I think working through with the satin stitches is going to look fantastic. So let me know if you guys have any questions. I hope you guys like all of the ideas and all the different ways to try it. And I hope you guys will try it. In the OML Embroidery Facebook group, I will leave the good image for you guys to play around with and see what you can come up with. So thanks everyone for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys will give this a try and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!